Hey y'all, Miles J here, and I am back again with another video. And today we're gonna be talking about clothes and fashion, particularly fast fashion. Today's video sponsor is, of course, Uvini. They told me that I can get at least $300 worth of stuff, which on their website isn't a lot. With that being said, let's dive right in, see what I got. Talk about the quality, get into all of that good stuff. Come join me. Hey girls. First things first, this Sailor Moon tube top, that's just what I'm gonna call it.
On their website, it is Sailor Moon embroidered sling top.
So this top I love, however, it originally came with these straps stitched into the back, and when I put it on, I swear one wasn't even stitched. Either that or I broke it immediately, and then this one I just ripped off.
Probably hard to see, but on this shirt there's a bunch of little strings, or just one string, holding everything together, at least these straps, because it was so easy to just rip this, which is something you're gonna encounter a lot when you're dealing with fast fashion brands. It just will come apart. Be careful about that. Always be cautious of that, okay? Since it does have straps, I was still able to tie it around my neck and make it like a tube top moment. I want to restitch it. Yeah, just like the way these were stitched into the back, it was just like really poor. This runs for $29.99, and for $30? No, no. 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 Y'all need to lower those prices, okay? The quality does not reflect the price. Or I should say, the price doesn't reflect the quality, because that should be $10. That's a sock with straps. Next is this Sailor Moon pajama set. The shirt, okay, front and back, the shorts. And the shorts have a little bow on the booty, it's really cute. I really like this pajama set. So the shirt and the shorts combo comes out to $41.19. Girl, what are we doing here? The shirt also has loose string syndrome, LSS. Girl, these prices still flabbergasting. Like, what in the heck? Next is this Why Always Me shirt. I found it very relatable and just like really bright and vivid, and I don't have a lot of yellow in my closet right now. I really wanted to diversify, you know, my color palette. Just try a different style. Ooh. So this decal feels like it'll probably last me a long time, because it just feels like straight up plastic. Some of y'all won't like that, because that means this, when this creases, it's like paper, you know, you'll just see. So this shirt is $31.89. As you can tell, we are seeing a trend with all of these items of clothing. Okay, I'm not falling for it. My viewers not falling for it. We all looking around the room like, girl, is she serious? I mean, I'm just asking. You know, I would really like to know that. Next is this beautiful, I actually really like this one. I think it's kind of a new spin, if only it had pockets. A new spin on the classic wrap your boyfriend's plaid around your waist trend, or that trend where you wrap plaid around your waist. This is definitely that, but it gives you, it is a skirt version of it. So you have sleeves here, and you tie the sleeves in the front, and then boom, you have like your own plaid shirt skirt moment. So it's short in the front, long in the back, so it gives you a cape effect, and you can show off your legs like how I love to do. What's this called, a Slayer patch? Is that a band? Yeah, I really don't have that many notes about it. Like, I like it. It has the elastic band. The elastic band hasn't shifted, and I've worn this a few times. The only thing I really don't like is that it doesn't have pockets, which it should absolutely have. So the price for that dress is $41.19. I feel like it just keeps getting higher the more we go on. Like, what is going on, y'all? Next item of clothing. This is actually the one I was most looking forward to. Normally I don't find brown articles of clothing like anywhere nowadays. Like, I feel like I used to see brown stuff all the time, but now like brown, which is my nude, like I cannot find it for the life of me. It'd be taking me so long. So finding this shirt, dress thing, whatever you want to call it, this blouse, honey, could not find anything like this anywhere, and I'm so happy I found it. Hate how I styled it in this video. Maybe I might reshoot that, who knows. But if I didn't, then yeah, I'm not a fan of how I paired it with that skirt, but you see the vision just if you look just at this, okay? So this fits so nicely on me. I was really scared it wouldn't fit all the way down my sleeves and I wouldn't be able to create that, you know, really beautiful, like you can just see the tips of your fingers coming out of the sleeve kind of effect. You know, it's super demure and you can do all kinds of like sleeve art with it. I was afraid I wasn't gonna be able to do that with this, and I was able. Something that people have made me self-conscious about is my little baby doll dresses and how they make me look like I'm pregnant. This is definitely one of those shirts that look like it could be maternity wear, but hey, maybe I'm into a little bit of maternity wear. Sometimes that shit goes off. Like, what can I say? I will never be blessed with child, but it doesn't mean I can't dress like I am. I feel like I got that glow anyway, you know? Why even worry about it? I think this is the material they were going for. I got this from a thrift store. It's like a very light, smooth texture. So good on the skin, great on a windy day, but it's also kind of transparent. But this texture is a little rougher and a lot heavier than this is. And it matches with my skin tone really closely. When do I ever get this close to my skin tone in clothing? Like, rarely. I love her, but let's read out this price. This is $32.99. Not as bad as I was expecting. Don't get me wrong, still expensive, but because I don't see outfits like this that often, I wouldn't mind spending that amount of money for this. That's how they get you. That really is how they get you. They starve you out, making you want things, and then they finally present it to you and it's at a crazy ridiculous price and you're like, I have no choice but to get it or else I'll never find it for another 20 years. Our last and final piece of clothing. These are boxer shorts. First of all, they're called highway sports shorts on the website. They say honey. There's a little envelope that says honey on it, okay? And the waistband acts as like a cincher slash like, I would say also back support. It just makes me feel like, and it's kind of hard to slouch in. Although, not necessarily impossible, but this is definitely one of my favorite pairs of shorts because fits my body right in that midsection area, right in that, you know, tummy section. So especially like when I'm feeling bloated or, you know, like kind of like, I like putting this on and it makes me feel just snatched. You know those days when you just, everything is crazy and you know things around you are falling apart and the only thing you really want to focus on is like looking good, because in the long run nothing really matters and one day you're not going to be here anymore and everything will seem so trivial. You guys know what I'm talking about, right?
So this makes me feel a lot better about that. It comes with two layers of shorts, so there's like these little boxers in between, okay? Like nice little support slash protection from, you know, seeing through this material, which is flows nicely in the wind. It actually feels great on a windy day, especially during summer when I don't want to wear that much clothing. Those shorts were $29.99. That was the cheapest clothing out of all of this so far. So those are all the clothes that I got from them. I also got some accessories, first starting with this Pikachu, okay? Pikachu is very bold. The girls are bold. And I know they ain't got the rights to this image, okay? But it's actually kind of cute. But I can tell the material is like that faux leather material, which is super easy to scratch. And as a matter of fact, the corner of this is already kind of like peeling off. I know this is not going to withstand the test of time. However, it is a very cute purse. And this Pikachu purse on their website is $23.99. But it comes with a clasp on the top, which I really like because I just feel safer with a little zipper moment or something to like actually close the bag rather than just like one of those things that has like a little clasp, but the two corners of your bag are like wide open for people to reach into. Don't really like those bags at all. Two more things. Sailor Moon wallet. This is my legit Samantha Vega Sailor Moon purse. This is like one of the only like luxury bag purchases I've ever made. I'm normally not like a luxury bag kind of person. When it comes to, of course, Sailor Moon stuff, and I was in Japan at the time, I was like, yeah, we gonna have to cop this one. I can tell that this wallet was based off of this collection. They are extremely similar, and it's a dupe. The original collaboration was between Samantha Vega and Sailor Moon. People caught wind of that, and they had to do They also made wallets, and this one on their website is $27.99. Quality of this wallet is actually pretty decent. It's got like leather feeling. The front is all etched and stuff like that. So you can put your ID in here and put a bunch of different cards in here, and there's part for your money. And it came with like a little sachet in there, so I just left it in there so that way my money smelled good. There's a bunch of different places where you can put your cards. And I actually really like this wallet, but I'm noticing it's starting to break down in the front here. There's like no seam that has been made. I think they just cut a hole for people to put their cards in, and now it's slowly starting to come apart on the inside. I've only had this for maybe a few weeks at best. I don't know, time is all over the place for me right now. June went by in a matter of seconds, but I really haven't been using it that long for it to be so distressed like that. Besides that, I feel like it's actually a really decent wallet, and $27 is probably a lot more than they charge to make it, but it's not necessarily a deal breaker for me. I mean, that is fucking expensive, but it's a lot cheaper than however much that original wallet is from this main high brand collection. I don't even remember how much this purse is. I tried not to remember, honestly, actively. Last thing we have here are these earrings, and I hope these earrings are the cheapest thing on here, okay? But these earrings are great earrings. So far, the gold, I've worn them a few times, and the gold hasn't washed off yet. I love that they are asymmetrical. One earring has the flower on top and the jewel on the bottom, and one has the jewel on top and the flower at the bottom. I love that they aren't the same. I'm starting to get into like the asymmetrical earring trend. I've always really liked it, honestly. That pair of earrings is $20.99. Still pretty expensive. From all of that, I also had another item that I request shipped. They were like these light up earrings, but they never got sent, and I don't know why. That has consistently happened. Whenever I requested clothing from this company within the budget, they've always forgotten to send one thing. Keep that in mind, because something tells me that if it keeps happening consistently, that's a problem. I think all of these items are extremely overpriced. However, they are fun to wear, nice to wear. The quality could be a lot better for... I was most disappointed by the quality of this. I mean, I knew it was gonna come in that sock quality, but I didn't expect the straps to fall apart. I mean, I was cautious of them. That's the thing. It's like, I didn't go into this like all ham and just throw on the shirt. Like, I knew the straps were gonna be, you know, sewed on by one string, and it still fell off. What does that say? That's not good at all. But my favorite article of clothing, I don't know if y'all could tell, is definitely this brown shirt. I'm sure you could probably find a cuter shirt for less in a brown color. But girl, maybe I should just use Google. I would say Uvimi is exactly what you think it is. It is a wholesale, very cheap quality clothing that raises their prices so that way they can make a huge profit off of making their clothes out of cheap material. That's what it is. But that being said, I will say their accessories are a lot better quality depending on what you pick. Like those earrings, those are pretty legit. Those are pretty decent. I like those. This purse, I think that this is a little bit on the cheaper side. This wallet, pretty legit. Even though it's deteriorating on the inside of these pockets, or this pocket in particular, the rest of the wallet is still holding up. I think it will hold up for a pretty long time. I'm happy it's so compact and cute because I can put it in my pocket now whenever I don't want to bring this big old giant purse. And it also matches with my purse, which is super cute. Like, look at that. Brow. Thank you guys all so much for joining me on today's Uvimi review. Thank you to Uvimi for sending me these clothes to review and to have fun with all of these cute outfits. And until next time, it's been me, Miles J, and I will see you guys all later. Bye!